Pleasure having you, Suzanne. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, time to call upon our next guest. To find a balance between the traditional and the modern, to stay true to age-old values of the reliability and trust. To bring new age technology and engineering is his blueprint for the Ashwin Seth Group. A visionary leader, inventor of Thane's Platinum Belt, he is highly motivated by the opportunities to lead at the world stage. His overriding passion for real estate and sharp business makes him a preeminent voice in the realty sector. Requesting ladies and gentlemen to please give a round of applause for the director of Ashwin Seth Group, Mr. Maulik Seth, to join us on stage, please. Pleasure having both of you here. I think so this was the time everybody was waiting, and we all were eagerly waiting for this brilliant association. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, today we all have gathered here to witness the momentous partnership between Suzanne Khan and the Ashwin Seth Group. So let's dwell deeper into the association of Suzanne and Maulik. I'll start with Suzanne with you. We have a lot of questions and everybody is really eager to have your answer. First of all, it's great to have you here. And before we get started, let's get a little understanding between your journey to the design world. I mean, what was that inspiration which made you to be a designer?
Firstly, I want to thank everyone for being here and appreciate your time. And we are very excited to announce this project because I think we have worked very hard to create a design that is come from the heart and a style that we want our families of this project to really enjoy. And with obviously Maulik and Meera and Seth Group. We are excited to, you know, announce this today. Coming back to your question of design, I think that the biggest motivation for me as a designer and as a person who has always been, completely, fascinated by the world of design and architecture, I think that for me, I want to give my clients and my families who come to us for their design solutions, super relaxed atmosphere in their homes where they can feel completely at ease, where they feel one with themselves, and where they get energized to work better in their lives and spend great time with their families. So as the designer, I want to create memories for them, and that's why we design these spaces, so that it converts into good memories and good moments. So I think that is my biggest motivation, is humankind, and I believe that design should always make a person and a space feel alive, and that is the greatest philosophy that I keep in my head when I design. Yeah.
Thank you. I guess that's really interesting and inspiring. But as you know that all the designers, they have their different style. So what according to you is your signature style and philosophy?
So for me, when I look at a space, I enter a space and it's gray and it's dark and there's no light and it's rubble because it's always in construction phase. And how we through my design company, The Charcoal Project, we believe that we need to ignite life into that space. So we choose to design a space where we mix in a concept, keeping in mind feminine and masculine. I feel that once, as a design company, we have a mix of like the feminine parts of design. So if when I talk about feminine, I would talk about, architecture like the Renaissance or even the Mughal period. All of this is very, there's a lot of motifs. Even the Mughal period is one of the most beautiful times in our history of art and architecture. So you take a lot of motifs and you take a lot of patterns from these areas. And then when you think about the very Frank Lloyd Wright stoic and very strong, industrial architectural design. So you bring in a lot of the mix of these two worlds of a strong, you know, stoic design and a very feminine design, and how you use this balance is what I keep in my head to create that perfect space. Yeah.
That's really amazing. Now, I think it's time to talk to Maulik. First of all, congratulations to the association with Suzanne. I mean, what are your thoughts about the association?
First of all, thank you all of you for taking out time and coming here today and listening to us, giving us an opportunity to talk about our association. At Ashwin Shade Group, we have always believed that our strength is design. Our motto is life by design. We have always designed square inches and not square feet. Right from the start, back in 2005 when it Beaumont and Prabha Devi, that was a new benchmark in luxury living. And we always are striving, trying to do better than ourselves, trying to set new benchmarks, and trying to give the best to our customers. And with this philosophy, the first name which came in our mind was Suzanne and the Charcoal Project. And I'm very excited with this collaboration. I'm very excited with this association. It has just started, and we are looking forward to a long journey ahead together. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Maulik. Yes, this is just the start of a very exciting design philosophies that we can develop together for our client and for our families. And I think that I am very, very excited about doing this project at this scale, at this level of details that we are working on. And so I'm excited to introduce to everyone that today we just started, but we will be showing them a lot more.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
I think it's very well wishing you very good luck with this. The next thing we want to know is, what was your inspiration behind this project? And finally, what is that one thing which made you have Suzanne Khan on board?
So, as a group, we have always tried to set new benchmarks and try to give us the best living experience to our customers. And when we thought about Shade Avalon, and we thought of Avalon as a project, we thought of giving the best luxury living experience to a customer in Thane, and that's how we thought of Suzanne. We started talking to her. We started this collaboration. We wanted to give that five-star touch, a five-star feel to our customers who are going to buy and stay in that project. We wanted to give them not just an address, but an iconic destination which they'll be proud of to live there in the future. And with her unparalleled design experience, her expertise, and that touch of opulence, I think it's the perfect mix, and the vision just matches, you know. So, yeah.
Thank you so much. I'm very humbled hearing your words. And
good things to talk about your work. So let's ask you, could you throw some light on your work and your foray into the real estate?
So honestly, this is one of the largest projects that we are designing for, as far as the public spaces, the amenities. We are doing the clubhouses, we are doing the lobbies, and we're also designing all these spaces for Avalon Thane in regard to, like I said, to thinking about the families and thinking about what these wonderful families are, wanting to have at the end of their day when they finish their, the kids when they finish their school, or the moms when they are, you know, wanting to just chill and relax. So I think that we have thought through for each family member and designed our common spaces and amenities, keeping all of this in mind. And I think that the entire my inspiration to design all of this was to keep in mind that this is an extension of their home, because in properties, that's why Avalon Thane is so I think forward thinking, and the Ashwin Sheth group has always been forward thinking, but with this project I think that they have taken it one step further, and we are defining their philosophy in the best we can, so that the owners of the home don't feel restricted to only their home. They feel that the entire property has extensions that they can hang out and enjoy. And so I think that is our drive and our ambition to make this one of a kind. And so that's how we are here today.
I'm sure your expertise, you're saying something.
I just agree with her on the point she said. Our vision with Avalon and her design and her philosophy matches so well, and it has turned out very nice, and I really appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's what her
just
expertise
the beginning now.
Yeah, it's just,
so
the,
just
beginning.
The beginning, because we have to still get it
it's
done.
It's just a sneak peek, ladies and gentlemen. It's a lot to more. So before you start, I think that every designer has a vision once you do a project. So what was your vision behind this?
Like I said, my vision is to make sure that these families have the most unbelievable feeling when they get home, where they feel like they are proud owners of this space, and they feel like they are superstars. They feel that they are really happy. They feel that they are they are also feeling relaxed. It's not like so uppity where you feel like you can't put your feet up and chill. You know, it's a relaxed luxury. I have a new philosophy in my head that even when you do luxury, and however opulent or however stylish you want to make it, you got to make it easy. The materials and the finishes should be easy, so children don't feel scared to drop ice cream or chill or, you know, walk around with dirty feet if they have to, because then only you will have a space that is more human. So I think that keeping all those points in mind, we have designed this space to be more human, to be more luxurious and human at the same time, and keeping the philosophy of making them feel at home. You know, that's the major thing that I kept at the back of my head.
We totally agree. I think so. We show that her design is going to enhance the luxury in every sense. But Molly, how are these elements going to be affecting or going to be making your residents' lives better? Any points on that, or anything you have to say about it?
Yeah. So when any developer gets a designer on board, you know, they do one maybe two show flats. They show the potential of their apartment, what can be inside. But what we have done this time is we have done the common areas, the lobbies, the clubhouse with Suzanne, and that is going to be permanent with them for life, for all those years that they're going to stay in my project. That experience, that feel is going to be with them permanent, and that's how it's going to change their living experience.
Right. And extend their homes.
Extension
of their home.
Right.
Thank you so very much. So then one more question, I think, so we have a lot of things to ask you. But whenever a designer goes for a project, like we've already talking about the vision, they also have a goal behind it. They also have a design elements. So what are your design elements which you are incorporating in this project?
So we have mixed a lot of different hard finishes. We have metal and a mixture of like bronze and brass and stainless steel mixed in with copper, various veneers, various wood finishes, various real wood finishes, various kinds of like lighting techniques and lighting styles that we have developed to make the space look a little bit more alive than what one would think of. The objects of art being oversized, maybe a little bit exaggerated, so that it gives the feeling of opulence in a very a cool way. So I think that we have used a lot of elements here in respect to hard finishes, in respect to technology. There are a lot of technology things that we are adding on to kind of like create the vibe of keeping the moods right, keeping the you know, the temperature, the climate, the sound. Even there is like we're going to infuse a smelling kind of you know, these incense into the air conditioning. So when you walk in here, you really feel like you can smell a great feeling, you know. So that there are a lot of elements here that we are incorporating to kind of like make this a holistic sixth sense feeling. It's not only about just visual, it'll be about the six senses, you know, about the touch and the feel and everything. So I think that is our philosophy here for this project. Yeah.
We all are very excited. We're looking forward, definitely. Before we move ahead, Maulik, any last thoughts, any last things you have in your mind to tell?
Yeah, sure. Just thank you all again coming today, giving us this opportunity to talk about our vision together, our collaboration with Suzanne and her team at Charcoal Project. We are looking forward to this association, and thank you again, Susan, for working
with
us.
Thank you, Maulik. Thank you so much.
I guess, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Suzanne. Thank you, Maulik, for throwing some light on the association. We're certain to have a great success, and definitely we're going to be creating milestones in the luxury housing market. Now, ladies and gentlemen on the media, if you have any questions, we can start with a session where you can throw some questions, because after this we have the unveiling. So requesting the media to please, if you have some questions.
My family is my backbone, and I think that no individual can work solo. They need the support of their family for keeping them loved and keeping them, you know, happy. When you're working, you need that backing. So yes, I think that my kids, my family, they all are my my support system, and because they keep me so happy, I can contribute to better design.
What made you choose a specific profession like interior designing?
I was always very fascinated by the world of architecture and interior design from a little girl of 5. My mom used to be an interior designer, and we used to get Architectural Digest magazines to our home. And I was 5 years old going through these magazines, and I fell in love with design. And I told myself that one day I want to be a very, very important part of this world. And I think that I have, every year I have gone closer and closer to my eventual goal.
What are the best architecture pieces in the world you have seen, ever seen, according to your opinion?
So for me, I think that my top 5 would be like Vatican City, because that is like the whole thing of the old world charm and the Renaissance and the Gothic and all of that mixed together. I think the other one would be the Eiffel Tower, because the Eiffel Tower has this excellent concept of using metal and making that metal feminine. Even though it's so big and it's so cold, it's very feminine. It's, when you think of the Eiffel Tower, you think of a woman, you know, a beautiful woman. And then there is Frank Lloyd Wright, who I love. So in California, when I was studying there, we used to keep going to these various houses done by Frank Lloyd Wright. So there is a house called the Prairie House, and there is Falling Waters. Falling Waters is a beautiful home which they did in the 70s, where there is a natural waterfall that's coming down from beyond the upper level of the house, and it goes into a natural kind of like a pond and river. And the house is right behind this whole thing. So that's another great architect who I love. I love Antonio Citterio. He is one of my, he's an Italian architect, and he's one of my top 5, because I feel that he's done the most beautiful property in the Mandarin Oriental Hotel in Bodrum, which is again very modern, but at the same time it's got that very warm vibe of relaxed luxury. And there is Philippe Starck, who does like the most beautiful properties all over. And I think that there are, you can't pick, because there is so much in the world of architecture and design. I would also love to say the Taj Mahal, because I think that India, we are so lucky to have that kind of architecture, and we are, our heritage is so strong with the entire Mughal period and the Rajput period, because that influences us today. Till today, we are influenced with patterns and designs. And I think that, being a student who has had the chance to be born and brought up from India and go and study in the West, I think the combination of both these worlds have made me the designer I am. And I think that is what the exposure has contributed to my design sensibility. Yeah. Thank you.
Anybody else apart from this gentleman?
Considering your buyer profile, what kind of research that you had to put in before designing this beautiful place?
So basically, we were working on the demographics of what is our client, what are the age group of the families who will be staying here, and exactly how many kids, what are the kids, are they younger, are they older? So firstly, we do a lot of kind of understanding of who the clients are. And once we understand what is the age group and what is their entire lifestyle, that's when we decide and we start our journey towards what are the amenities that will add value to their lives. So so I think that was the first thing that we started off from. And then I wanted to create, and we want to create these spaces in such a way that it is for all the five the senses, which can be, you can feel evoked, and you feel like when you enter that zone, it's the smell, it's the sound, it's the sight, all those things, and even the touch. So I think that keeping in mind these few things, we started off on the journey of designing this project. Yeah, yeah.
Anybody else?
Maybe one day in my life. Right now, no such plan. But God willing, one day, maybe a design philosophy book. Yeah.
Thank you, all of you.
Thank you so much for those lovely questions. And thank you so much for being here and being a part of our, introduction to this beautiful project. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you.
I guess, ladies and gentlemen, now is the time. We also have, we are joined by one more guest, and we have the director, Chintan Seth from the Ashwin Seth Group, requesting Chintan Seth to please join us for the felicitation for Suzanne. Can we have the bouquet as well? Requesting Chintan to please say a few words about the association we have with Suzanne.
Thanks. Firstly, thank you all of you to come here today and give us this opportunity to showcase what we plan coming in for Thane, especially with our association with Suzanne. And we are really, really hoping that it's going to create something something special, and it's going to give Thane a bigger landmark than probably the mall we have made in the past. So that's been our hope and our endeavor, and all the best to Suzanne, and thanks again all of you for being part of this. Thank you.
Thank you, Chintan. Ladies and gentlemen, now is the time we move forward with the grand unveiling of Suzanne's design for the Seth Avalon. And requesting, let's have.
Center, it's okay. The unveiling is happening now.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's the unveiling of Suzanne's design for the Seth Avalon. Let's have a huge round of applause. This is the amazing style. Requesting all three of you to please be in the center for the photo. Be in the center. We'll remove this. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time. We'll have now look to the walk through St. Avalon. Requesting all three of you, requesting Suzanne, Chintan and Molly. Let's
I am very excited to be a part of the Ashwin Sheth group. This is going to be one of the milestone projects of Thane city, Avalon Thane, and we are proud to introduce amenities and lifestyle design which we are creating very specially for the families of this beautiful building and this beautiful development. And I think that along with Malik and Meera Sheth, the vision of their of what they are wanting to keep in mind, and with Charcoal Project coming together, it's a great association, and we are very excited about taking this to actually convert into reality. आई थिंक सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट होना चाहिए कि वो फीलिंग जो फैमिली जो वहाँ पे रह रही है या जो डेवलपमेंट या जो रेस्टोरेंट जो भी है जो भी वो जगह के अंदर जो आ रहे हैं उनको जो फीलिंग हो रहा है वो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है कि उनको क्या महसूस हो रहा है कि जब वो आए वहाँ पे. तो मेरा पूरा डिज़ाइन फिलॉसफी एक चीज़ है कि आई नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट हुएवर इज़ गोइंग टू बी देयर हैज़ टू फील वेरी refreshed, energetic, excited. So the important thing about design is that one should keep in mind what are the people or what are the families you are designing for, and then from that you keep making the journey of the design style. It will be very new because we are trying out a lot of new things here. We are trying to mix products, and we are trying new design for our lighting concepts. We are trying new design for various furniture and objects of art. So there will be a lot of new design here. I'm not going to tell you everything because it's no fun then.
अभी जो भी recently design हुए आपके यहाँ पे जो मुंबई में हुए कांजीरमा जो थाने में तो क्या मुंबई के बाहर भी देखने को मिलेंगे हमें?
मुंबई के बाहर डिज़ाइन किधर जी मुझे समझ में नहीं आया. हाँ ये तो थाने में है ना, तो मुंबई के बाहर है. हम भी बहुत पुणे में किए हैं एंड वी हैव डन इन दिल्ली. तो हम काफ़ी कर रहे हैं. बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ गॉड आई थिंक आई एम वेरी लकी. वी गॉट अ वेरी गुड बैंक ऑफ क्लाइंट्स एंड गुड पीपल एंड गुड फैमिलीज दैट वी आर वर्किंग विद. आई थिंक इट्स नॉट माई प्लेस टू विश ऑन दैट. ओके, थैंक यू, बाय.